Osteomyelitis refers to the inflammation of the medullary portion or the marrow space of the bone. But in a broader sense, osteomyelitis is used to describe an inflammatory process affecting the marrow and extending to the cortex as well as the periosteum of the bone. Suppurative osteomyelitis of the jaw is a condition when an inflammatory process in the medullary portion of the bone leads to edema and pus accumulation in the marrow spaces. Now this accumulation of purulent exudate builds up medullary pressure and obstructs the local blood supply, leading to necrosis of the bone. So there are many different types of osteomyelitis. In fact, several classification systems have been proposed to group these conditions, which have unfortunately resulted in a lot of confusion. Broadly, there are osteomyelitis lesions causing suppuration and those not causing suppuration. Suppurative osteomyelitis has an acute and a chronic form. This disease is characterized by formation of pus, fistulae, and sequestrum. Non-suppurative osteomyelitis, on the other hand, comprises a group of chronic conditions where there is no suppuration or formation of fistula. This group includes chronic focal sclerosing osteomyelitis, chronic diffuse sclerosing osteomyelitis, and chronic osteomyelitis with proliferative periostitis, also called Garay's osteomyelitis. There is another classification called the Zurich system, which employs a simple classification categorizing osteomyelitis as acute osteomyelitis, primary chronic osteomyelitis, and secondary chronic osteomyelitis. Now, the acute and secondary chronic osteomyelitis refer to the acute and chronic suppurative forms of osteomyelitis, respectively. The primary chronic osteomyelitis is used synonymously with chronic diffuse sclerosing osteomyelitis. The synonymous usage of these terms is common in German and continental European medical and dental literature. Okay, so let's just quickly go through the gross histology of bone so that we can better understand the pathophysiology behind suppurative osteomyelitis. So most bones, like the mandible for example, have a rigid outer compact bone or cortex forming an outer shell surrounding a medullary cavity or a marrow cavity. The outside of the compact bone is lined by periosteum. The medullary cavity houses the medullary or a cancellous bone comprising numerous interconnected bony trabeculae. Now apart from the trabecular or cancellous bone, medullary cavity also harbors bone marrow and blood vessels. The bulk of the cortical bone is made of concentric lamellae. Now, concentric lamellae make up the basic metabolic unit of bone and are called osteons or haversian systems. These haversian systems have cylindrical canals called haversian canals housing blood vessels and nerves. These haversian canals communicate with each other as well as the periosteum and the marrow space via canals called Wolkmann canals. Now, Wolkmann canals, like the haversian canals, also contain blood vessels. And this system of interconnected haversian and Wolkmann canals supplies nutrients and nourishes the bone. Acute and chronic suppurative osteomyelitis are the same disease in different stages of their course. They are separated by an arbitrary time limit of 1 month. Hence, an acute suppurative osteomyelitis that continues its course without subsiding beyond an arbitrary time limit of more than 4 weeks is considered to be chronic suppurative osteomyelitis. Suppurative osteomyelitis, strictly speaking, is a true infection of the bone caused by pyogenic microorganisms. It is a polymicrobial disease with Staphylococcus aureus, Staphylococcus albus, and Staphylococcus epidermidis being the major pathogens. Anaerobes like Privertula, bacterioids, and Porphyromonas have also been cultured from the diseased site. However, other factors like radiation and traumatic injuries like gunshot wounds or traumatic extractions and surgeries could also cause the disease. Apart from these factors, there are several systemic and local conditions that could alter vascularity of the bone, predisposing it to suppurative osteomyelitis. Now, suppurative osteomyelitis of the jaw is primarily caused by infections, usually from infected teeth or periodontium. and there is a delicate balance maintained between the microorganisms and the host immune system. Otherwise, every tooth infection or periodontal disease could result in osteomyelitis. Now, factors favoring microorganisms are their number and their virulence, and factors in favor of the host are host immunity and the local blood supply to tissues. So anything that could cause an increase in number and virulence of the microorganisms, or a decrease in the host immunity and the local blood supply, could result in infections causing suppurative osteomyelitis. So microorganisms elicit an inflammatory response and can locally cause an increased vascular permeability, leading to accumulation of plasma fluids. Leukocytes are recruited to the site of inflammation and release numerous proteolytic enzymes that cause tissue damage and necrosis. Inflammatory responses also induce thrombus formation in blood vessels, causing ischemia and necrosis. So as plasma fluids and pus accumulate in the medullary cavity, they increase the medullary pressure, causing a vascular collapse and help in further progression of ischemia and necrosis in the marrow cavity. This pus accumulating inside the medullary cavity could also compress the inferior alveolar nerve, causing paresthesia. Further, pus moves through the medullary spaces and reaches the cortex. Here, the pus starts to trickle in through the Wolkmann canals and the Haversian systems to accumulate below the periosteum. This compromises the periosteal blood supply and may cause further lifting and perforation of the periosteum, causing pus to accumulate under the mucosa, leading to fistula formation and drainage of pus in the oral cavity. And when bone fragments die due to ischemia, these fragments are separated from the normal bone by osteoclastic activity. These separated necrotic fragments of bone are called sequestra. Suppurative osteomyelitis can occur in both males and females at any age. Mandible is more often affected than the maxilla, and this is because maxilla has a rich blood supply as compared to the mandible. For the mandible, its major source of supply is the inferior alveolar artery. And also, since maxilla has thinner cortical plates and lesser medullary bone, infections readily diffuse into the soft tissues and sinuses. Patients with the acute form of the disease may have intense pain, swelling of the jaw, trismus, and a rise in temperature. There may be pus exuding out through the gingival sulcus. Patients may have paresthesia of the lower lip due to compression of the inferior alveolar nerve. The symptoms in the chronic form of the disease are milder than the acute form, with pain and swelling being less severe. The chronic disease is characterized by the formation of fistula and sequestra formation. Fistula could be on the mucosa or even cutaneous, with pus exuding through the skin. Under the radiograph, acute suppurative osteomyelitis does not show any changes readily. Rather, it takes at least 2 weeks for changes to be noticeable in the radiograph. The acute disease shows radiolucent changes in the radiograph. These radiolucencies are fuzzy, mottled, and blotchy with ragged borders. And when the disease becomes chronic, dead bone tissues or sequestra are visible in the radiograph as radiopaque masses surrounded by fuzzy or blotchy radiolucencies. Treatment for suppurative osteomyelitis involves the use of antibiotics and surgical intervention. The diseased site must be cultured to identify specific pathogens for a definitive antibiotic treatment. Surgical intervention involves debridement, drainage of pus, and irrigation of the diseased site. Surgery may also involve resection and removal of the sequestrum and the diseased bone with autologous bone replacement. Thank you.